Right. All right. We are here, guys. It is the game one of a best of one. It's going to be Team Sponsor Us versus NWFSC. Team Sponsor Us being on the left and NWFSC being on the right side. Let's go ahead and do a formal introduction of the team. As I mentioned, Team Sponsor Us is going to be on the order side of the map, left side of the spectator UI, bottom side of the mini-map. It's going to be Bibomb Boop playing Kali in the jungle, Data Remember and Cardiac playing Medusa and Athena in the duo lane. Cute is going to be playing Scylla in the mid, and it's going to be Osoth playing Tyr in the solo lane.
And on the right side of your spectator UI, top side of the mini-map, red team is going to be NWFSC Hashling Slashers with Arc9 on Kronos in the mid lane, Lord of Evil on Sirkette in the jungle, Treefitty on Rama as your AD carry, Behemothal on Kumbakarna as your support, and Brickkiller on Vamana in the solo lane.
Yeah, so just looking around here, it looks like there's a little bit of action over on the right-hand side, likely just some ward coverage going out. Definitely something that you want to do with these teams. Kali and Tyr having both a fairly strong clear in the early, not weak, but not super strong by any means. But Vamana Sirkette has also pretty much equal clear, I would say. As we see a Soulstone start up for Scylla, this item actually received a recent buff where at max stacks you now have 60 power instead of 30 on your next damaging ability. That makes Scylla, and Scylla also has a red pot, or a purple pot.
That's a lot of damage.
Yeah, that is going to really make Scylla shine in the early game where she's really weak. As you can see, she's pretty much almost full clearing the minions already. Just a couple auto attacks each one. Yeah, Scylla is going to have a very strong early game here. Sirkette getting that taunt off and a little bit of damage onto Cute. Wow, that's a lot. Kronos, oh my god, Arcanine gets the first blood onto Cute with the time stop into the time rift. Wow, that is a early 450 pot gone immediately. NWFSC starting off strong in the mid lane, as the mid camps are going to be taken by Arc and Lord over on the left-hand side there.
That was an interesting kill, J-Mac.
I wasn't expecting that kind of early aggression, but I mean, both of them can clear the wave fairly well. Scylla obviously had the stronger clear at the early part, but they just immediately aggressed into it, and Arc9 hitting that very beautiful time stop there was able to guarantee that he could get the time rift on, or the stop time, I guess that's what it's called. As we look over into the duo lane, the wave clear, obviously, as we mentioned earlier, it's going to go more in favor of Medusa. Both of them electing to go into the throwing dagger start. I mean, there's no reason not to. It's like the best item for a hunter in the game at the moment. The Mez comes out from Kumbakarna. Shield wall from Athena, not going to do too much as the wave is going to be pushed back into the tower once again. Looking over in the solo lane, it's pretty much even. I mean, this is what you expect between Vamana and Tyr. Tyr gets a nice Fearless onto Vamana. It's going to push him back a little bit there.
We have the warrior poke fight going on over here in the solo lane. Looks like Tyr's getting a lot of damage. He's probably going to get the power cleave off. Going to do some decent damage if he can actually catch Brickkiller. He gets the damage, and the dash comes out, and Brickkiller is going to get away. And, yeah. You know, standard clear coming out after that. Looking back in the mid lane, Cute and Bibomb Boop actually struggling to clear these waves with the pressure coming out from Lord of Evil and Arc9.
Yeah, it looks like the Crush was thrown out there to try and take away those mid camps, but they got him out just in time there. So both mid camps going the way of NWFSC. That's going to give them an early golden experience lead. As you can already see, it's already about an 800 gold lead for them, which at two minutes, that's not a huge thing. Over half of that is just the first blood gold. But Scylla already going to have a really tough time being a kill down and also being 450 gold down from the purple pot. Scylla's going to be in a rough position for the early portion of this game. It's really going to take a late game fight, as in the duo lane, Lord of Evil makes a gank at level 5, now level 6 onto against Athena using the ultimate. Data Remembers beads have been popped. Looks like a little bit of damage is going to come out, but they're not going to be able to further aggress into it. That's going to be another kill going the way of NWFSC.
Yeah, I think they may have been able to get that kill, to be honest, if they would have went in, but it looks like they might just get it now. No, actually, Q comes in and gets the kill on Lord of Evil. Meanwhile, Behemothal just running away, but I'm a Monster comes out.
Yeah, looks like that's going to be possibly a kill here on the Behemothal. I don't think he's going to be able to get out of that one. Passive was popped, but Data Remember is going to get the auto attack to finish that one off. Great rotation from Cute there. He's going to actually pick up two kills for his team, one for Cute and one for Data Remember. That's going to, for the most part, even this game back up here.
Yeah, I mean, Q is going to be able to, you know, getting those kills is actually going to allow him to get back in the game even after losing that purple pot.
Yeah, it was a great rotation. It was an unexpected one from NWFSC. Nobody really expects the level 5 gank into the duo lane. But at the same time, Cute was already on the way making his rotation, was able to pick up a return kill onto Lord Evil, and then managed to also pick up the one onto the support. So Street50 was able to get out of that. So support and jungle for the support, I believe, in that case. Definitely a little bit more in favor of TSU with that one.
Definitely. Although the game, you know, it's pretty even right now. Looking at the gold and the kills, it's incredibly close. So this game is still up to go either way, to be honest. And it being a best of one, both teams are going to have to try their absolute hardest to make sure that they don't get sent to the loser bracket, because that is a tough run from the loser's bracket all the way back to the grand finals.
Yeah, that's going to be a really tough road for anybody who gets thrown in there early on. Medusa actually ahead of Tree50 now with that kill to his name, getting a little bit of extra experience there. So it's going to be a slight level advantage in favor of Medusa over Rama. Actually, it's a very sharp difference. I think it's about a level and a half from what I saw in the experience on that one. As Tree50 is going to go ahead and clear the way with those Astral Arrows, give himself a little bit of extra free farm now the Behemothal has rotated out of the lane. I'd say that's one of the struggles with some of our teams that we've had, is the support not leaving lane really early enough. Some of our teams, I think most notably Delta and PU, Take a Bath, both of their supports tend to stay in lane a little bit too long and actually take the farm to hold up there. We got a gank over in the right hand side. Osats is going to go ahead and use the Lawbringer away. Arcanine is going to miss that time rift onto him. As a full gank, Athena's ultimate has been expended as well. They're going to make a counter initiation here. Two man taunt comes out. Purification has been popped by Arcanine. Brick Killer's going to go into Big Baby. Cute's going to go ahead and drop the ultimate down. It's going to take out Brick Killer. The Mez is going to come through as well. That's going to hit Bibomboot and Cardiac, both on the chase, but I think that stop time is going to stop that one there.
Yeah. I'd like to point out the ward coverage actually coming out from NWFSC on the left side. They have 4 wards covering basically all entrance points over on the left side.
Yeah, a lot of ward coverage coming out from NWFSC. As another Mez is coming out from the mid lane there. A lot of aggression over in the duo lanes as well.
Yeah, it's... I haven't seen too much coming out from the duo lane, actually, myself. I've been paying attention mostly to... what's his name? Lord of Evil. He's been getting pretty good ganks coming off, even if they haven't all been successful. They've been pretty good so far.
Yeah. Over in the left-hand side, it's just more aggression from the solo lane. It's going to be Brick Killer's kind of winning out the poke war here, but it's not a huge deal. Tier's just going to be able to heal that up. That's one of the beauties of Tier, is he's going to be able to clear that wave very easily, not really have any kinds of problems with that.
Yeah. Meanwhile, pretty standard stuff coming out, just gathering farm all around the map. And, you know, there's these calm moments in Smite. I mentioned this before. It goes from, like, intense action where everybody's dying to just everybody chilling and, like, nothing really happening. And, you know, those moments are just great because I can actually talk without having to speak a million miles an hour.
Yeah. Having a little bit of a awkward client on mine. It's kind of speeding up and slowing down randomly for me here, so
yeah, same.
Forgive me for a little bit of my lack of commentary on that one. As we see a little bit of aggression here over at the red buff, it's going to be Cute actually gets hit with a stop time there. A little bit of poke coming out for him. He's going to go ahead and disengage that one as the red buff is taken for NWFSC.
Yeah, and right now it looks like... We're just getting back to the standard stuff. The engagements are coming on and off from TSU and NWFSC. They're kind of just engaging, not really getting much, like maybe a buff, maybe a camp, and then they're disengaging, and it's kind of awkward watching it, to be honest, especially, you know, since the client has that issue where it likes to slow down and speed up.
Yeah, I think we were able to get that solved out just now. Looks like it's working just fine for... Looks like it's coming back fine for me. Going over into dual lane, Defender of Olympus is coming out. Another engagement onto Osoth. He's going to go ahead and ult out of there. Not sure if they're going to be able to pick up the kill on him. Yeah, Lord Evil's going to get the credit. That's the last breath poison is going to be enough to finish him off. Bibomb Boop's looking to re-engage, but there are two people there, and he's not going to be able to go in on a Kumbakarna there. That Mez and the Root is going to be more than enough to stop Bibomb Boop from being able to go in on that.
Yeah, well... Osath died there. I was wondering, I was like, wait, did nothing happen again?
No, Osath fell there from the last...
Oh, no, they're not doing Gold Fury. I thought they were doing a Gold Fury here. That would have been intense. I mean, they may have had it, because most of the TSU members were on the right side. Meanwhile, an engagement coming out here. Bimon Boop actually, Arc 9 throwing out the stun, getting it on Cardiac, getting the extra damage. And looks like a disengagement coming out. It keeps happening. There's such awkward engagements for some reason.
Yeah, it's just little bits of poke war coming out there. And I'd say in that instance, it may have gone the way of Team Sponsor Us, the Crush doing a lot of damage to Arc 9 in that situation. As Data Remember is getting very aggressive in the jungle, Stop Time's going to come out on the top end. As the Kumbakarna's ultimate's going to come out, Epic Uppercut's going to slam Cardiac down. He's very low in HP. Mez going to come to stop as the Petrify comes out from Medusa. It's going to hit two. Arc 9's not going to be able to rewind out of that one. Too little, too late there, buddy. Behemothul is coming around the backside onto Bibomb Boop, who looks like he's trying to go onto Lord of Evil. Don't think he's going to be able to chase that one out. As Trufitti does go into the sky, who's he going to go against? Looks like he's going to try and deal some damage to Bibomb Boop's. Not going to be enough. It's just Brick Killer is here as well. Osoth made his rotation. It's a full rotation over here just to get these back harpies. This all started with a fight at the back harpies while Arcanine was trying to take them.
Yeah, I mean, Arcanine, as he was taking those, they got engaged on, and he had to waste his rewind. Even though it didn't take the cooldown, he used it, and he got killed from the Petrify, and Medusa's auto attack, I believe, finished off. Meanwhile, Data Remember actually putting some nice damage on this tower while Lord Evil comes over and gets... the beat's coming out from Data Remember, the jump coming out, and it looks like they probably won't be able to secure this kill on him because Athena's coming over. I'm not sure, they're doing mad work, but Data Remember's gets ulted, and right now Cardiac just has to run away.
Yeah. Purification was forced out of Data Remember there, but it didn't really matter. The ultimate from Lord Evil was able to come out and secure another kill. That's three kills going the way of the jungler at the moment. Athena's going to go ahead and have to clear out those minions there. Since Data Remember is dead, no point in holding those. Just get a little bit of free experience while you can.
Yep, and right now it looks like Lord Evil and Arcanine heading to the mid lane. While Osath is actually taking his blue buff... Bibomb Boop, actually. I was forgetting who Bibomb Boop was, to be honest. Meanwhile, we have Brick Killer and Lord Evil taking their blue buff. Looks like the Gold Fury was pinged. Looks like they might be trying to get ward coverage on it, or they may be... Is there a ward under the Gold Fury, it looks like?
There is a ward under the Gold Fury, but there's also a Sentry Ward from TSU there, so I'm surprised they haven't gone over to take that. They might be making the rotation there now. I'm not sure if that's a Sentry Ward there.
No, that's directly another ward.
Yeah, Taunt from Cardiac is going to come out. It's going to do quite a bit to Lord of Evil. The second hit's going to hit Arc 9. Sikkim is going to miss, so that's going to go ahead and disengage that one. Looks like Gold Fury is being pulled there. Now they're just going to go ahead and get Osoth gets
kill him,
a solo kill. That's interesting. All right. But yeah, that was just a regular ward there that's going to be taken from the Gold Fury. As a little bit of damage is being pumped into Cardiac there, but he is the support. He does have a little bit of extra defenses on him at the moment, but... Early game supports aren't really all that tanky compared to the rest. Another gank coming over on Data. Remember, the Root's gonna come out, Defender from Olympus. Petrify is gonna come out as the last breath. Dina's gonna try and do something here. The poison's gonna spread, the epic uppercut. And another ult. Three ultimates expended. They're gonna get a double kill for Lord of Evil over in the duo lane. They're doing a lot of work to try and shut down Data.
Looks like the Gold Fury is being started here, and oh wow, Arcanine actually having to ult to get out. Meanwhile, I'm a monster coming out. Looks like it went down. I don't know if it hit anybody.
No, it completely missed Arc. It completely missed Arcanine there. As Trufitti is going to pick up Bibomb Boop, the Gold Fury is being re-aggressed on, but Osoth is here to make sure that doesn't quite happen.
Yeah, it was a good Gold Fury attempt. Unfortunately, nothing really came from it, except I believe they did get the kill on Bibomb?
Yeah, they got the kill on the Bibomb Boop. You might go ahead and hit the resync option there. That might help fix your problem if you're still having the issue. As the mid-camps are being taken by Brick Killer on the right-hand side. Left-hand side ones are sure to be spawning up here in about the next 15 to 20 seconds. Qt is just trying to figure out something to do here. He's sitting same level as Arc at the moment, but really he... hasn't been able to do much. And despite all of what's happened here, Day Remember is still a level ahead of Tree Fitty. And Lord Evil is only a level ahead of Bibombo. So all these ganks have not really been producing too much here. Gold Fury has been started. Taunt's going to come out to stop Behemoth Ball. And that's going to be a Gold Fury going the way of Team Sponsor Us. I'd say pretty much absolutely free. Only
yeah,
one who came to stop that was Behemoth Ball.
There were a few abilities that were used to stop Behemoth Ball, but nothing really happened that really could have warranted it not being free. Meanwhile, some aggression being thrown at the Lord of Evil, but nothing really happening, that ward being taken. And everybody's kind of grouping up at the mid lane.
Yeah, this is the standard group up here, although normally just Athena, not Tyr. Don't know why Osoph has made his rotation here. Brick Killer is also in the mid, so four-man group up in the mid as the taunt comes through. It's going to hit two. Purification is going to be forced for both. Crush is going to hit two as well. So Purification almost kind of going to waste there. Now that those are on cooldown, that's a full sign to re-engage on the enemy as soon as they get the chance to. Another rotation's coming over here for Lord Evil as he's trying to be a little bit aggressive in the at the red buff, but Defender of Olympus is forced out of Athena. I think they were just trying to bait that one. Cardiac is here. Taunt comes out from Cardiac as well as Lord of Evil. Lord is going to miss. Arcanine's going to do a little bit of auto-attack damage onto Cardiac. It's a nice time rip. Stop Tom is just going to be off the mark, but that sprint was popped anyways to get Cardiac out. So that's Defender of Olympus and the sprint out of the support now.
Meanwhile, it looks like there's going to be some aggression being thrown to Bibomboop, but just two abilities wasted over from Lord of Evil. It was a good attempt, and they forced out the jump, possibly looking to force out the ult so they could get a good engagement next fight. Meanwhile, it looks like Brick Killer is going to go ahead and back after Osath gets his blue buff, and Osath, he's actually there, but he's the same level as Brick Killer. I think they're the only people who are even right now. Oh no, Cute and Arcanine are even.
Yeah, actually Arcanine now having a little bit of a lead on the Cute at the moment.
Oh.
Yeah, and Cute actually getting a kill onto Lord of Evil. Looks like probably the Crush was thrown out there. Maybe the ultimate. I don't recall if that one was on cooldown at the moment, as Bibomboop is going to go ahead and take the Fire Elementals. Let's be honest, Bryce. How often do you go for those Fire Elementals as a solo laner?
As a solo laner, if there's not anything to do in my lane, I go for it. If there's no pigs, if there's no wave, if I've already pushed the enemy solo laner out, I go for it. Meanwhile,
this is a four-man rotation.
Brick Killer, the Crush. Oh my goodness, so much CC. A great CC chain coming out from Team Sponsor Us, just putting Brick Killer in the grave immediately.
Yeah, there was really nothing that Brick Killer could do. He didn't have a moment to where he could drop the Big Baby. In fact, he didn't even have Big Baby available for him. So there was no way for him to get out of that engagement. They were able to stop the dash, and there was really just nothing he could do at that.
Osath getting a blink fearless onto two people, Arcanine and Behemothal. Meanwhile, ulting into Arcanine and Behemothal, getting ulted by Behemothal, and it looks like he's getting engaged on the ultimate coming out, putting Behemothal into the sleepy form. Meanwhile, Lord of Evil having to dash out. Osath dying from Lord of Evil's ultimate.
Last breath. Behemothal is going to come out of the sleepy form just in time. Not enough auto attacks were thrown in him. Arcanine is going to go ahead and rewind out, but he is not in a good spot. He's going to need to throw out that stop time. He's going to hit two of them, but it's not going to matter. Cute's going to throw out the Crush and secure that kill.
Yeah, that was a great fight for both teams. They both made pretty good plays there. Lord of Evil getting the last breath onto Osath, putting him in the grave. I mean, Osath, though, had a great engagement. It's just he was by himself. Cardiac did come in, but nothing really happened off of that. Meanwhile, Bibomboop progressing on a Brick Killer, getting good damage and dash coming out. Meanwhile, this mid lane actually being aggressed on pretty hard. Three people versus three people in the mid lane.
Yeah, now the Behemothal is back. The taunt was expended from there. No purification was forced, and I'd say it was good that Lord Evil didn't pop his purification there. It would have kind of been a waste. There wasn't really a whole lot of follow-up, maybe a Sikkim Crush at the most, but at that point, that's when he would know if he needed to pop the purification. So just seeing that the taunt hits is good for him to not have to force that one out. Over here, Data Remember has just been getting a little bit of solo experience, now level 17 ahead of Brick Killer experience-wise and gold-wise. Data Remember, despite all the ganks that's been happening in his lane, he's been staying very strong on his farm. Tree Fitty just popping into level 16, so a full level behind his opponent.
Yeah, that's pretty interesting, actually, seeing that full level being there. I haven't really noticed too much farm difference, but I guess Data Remember has just been on it right now. Meanwhile, three people still in the mid lane for Team Sponsor Us, putting great pressure on Brick Killer, rotating in, getting damage on a Bibomboop, gonna force the jump out here. Meanwhile, Behemothal forcing Cute to jump out, Cardiac being CC'd there, whatever the CC's called, Yawn.
Top. Oh, the Yeah, there's not going to be a chance for him to rewind. Done having at the moment. Last Breath is going to come off on the left-hand side. Bivon Blue could be forced into his ultimate. Lord of Evil is going to fall, and the Last Breath is not going to last long enough. Bivon Blue is going to be able to get out of that using his ultimate. Great use of the ultimate, not popping it immediately by Bivon Blue, waiting a couple ticks of Last Breath to ensure that he can't die from the dot damage of it.
Yeah, and looks like pressure going here to the mid lane again. Looks like Team Sponsors is really trying to pressure down this mid lane, trying to force Arcanine to, you know, not get farmed, not make it to the late game, while Behemothal being pushed. Looks like the taunt's coming out too, and the ultimate coming out from Behemothal, and Osat's going to try to re-engage with the sprints coming out. Looks like they're just going to go ahead and disengage over from WFSC. Meanwhile, looks like the Gold Fury might be jumped on.
It looks like it, but it looks like they might instead be trying to get a gank on a Trifitty, as a lot of people are coming for this rotation. The crust is going to be thrown out. Nothing's going to happen for that. I think that's a decent sign for them to maybe start aggressing towards the Gold Fury. They do have a ward there, if I recall correctly. But it looks like more pressure is going to be put up. Osoth being in the front line at the red buff at the moment. They're really trying to put the pressure into here, put Arcanine a little bit behind. He's two levels behind his opponent at the moment. Qt is doing a very good job farming. Despite the early kill that happened onto him, he's doing a great job. Kali's starting to come online, though. It's one thing we didn't mention. Kin-sized Vitalis and the Stone Cutting Sword is going to be the next item coming up for Kali. I think maybe about, let's see. Kali is sitting at 750 gold in hand, so that's still going to be another 900 gold before he's able to get that Stone Cutting Sword online. So it's going to be a little bit before Kali really starts doing anything, but even still, at the moment, he's sitting at 3-1, which is not something you want to have on a Kali is kills.
Yeah. Kali, once she gets in the late game, is pretty unstoppable. But looking at it right now, it looks like there's some ward battles going on. Props to both teams, actually, for the sheer amount of wards being placed. Meanwhile, Cardiac using the taunt on a Trifitty. Trifitty rolling out while Arcanine is coming in. Petrify coming out on the Trifitty in the back, but doesn't look like any other damage is going to come out. Meanwhile, Arcanine chasing out Cardiac. Lord of Evil going on to Qt, but nothing coming out from it. The crush being wasted, too. Looks like a full disengagement is going to be coming out here.
Yeah, as you were saying, a lot of wards have been placed by this team. Both of the supports have placed 9 and 10 wards between the two of them. Mid lane, NWFSC really has been doing a great job placing wards. I think that there's been almost 30 wards, 25 to 30 wards placed by them, as the Gold Fury is being taken by Data Remember here. No, it's just being leashed back and forth. Aggression over at the red buff. Damage coming out. Bivon Boop's going to be forced out. He does have his ultimate, but doesn't want to have to waste it just yet. Brick Killer getting a nice umbrella ring to disengage the team through the slow out there.
Lord of Evil actually forced out before any of that happened. Good fight possibly could have came out from Team Sponsors. Looks like they're going to do it now. The beat's coming out from Arcanine, and the Stop Time coming out. Time Rift coming out too. Trifitty looks like he's getting focused down right now. The Sprint coming out from WFSC.
Big Baby being thrown out. He's going to be thrown onto Osoth. He does have the Frostbound Hammer, so it's going to slow him down a little bit. Taunt's going to be missed from Lord Evil. I think that's going to be the disengage there. Stop Time and Time Rift are both going to miss. Data Remember's going very aggressive on Arcanine. He's 5 levels ahead of him. There's no reason for him to not be. Defender of Olympus is going to come out. The Fearless is going to push Brick Killer against the wall. Athena is here. Taunt's going to come out. Brick Killer's not in a good spot here. He's going to throw out the slow, but he's likely to fall here. Bivon Boop's going to get credit for that kill. Last Breath is going to come out onto Qt. Lord of Evil is going to pick up a return kill for it.
Meanwhile, Data Remember actually going aggressive on to Lord of Evil and getting that kill with those auto attacks. And it looks like they're going to try to aggress onto Trifitty as Data Remember. Actually, they're going to try to take this Gold Fury while Osath and Cardiac zone out from the.
Yeah, the dom from the Viper shot was what actually got the kill for them on that one. All three shots, two snipes coming through. The third one's finally going to come through for Trifitty there. Gold Fury has still not been leashed. Team Sponsors is going to get the credit for that one. The Petrify is only going to hit one. Arcanine not in a good spot. He's sitting half HP, no health. The Human Bolt is going to fall down into the Sleepy form. They're going to ignore him, try and get the kill onto Arcanine. Bivon Boop's going to get the credit to the kill on Trifitty as they're going to make their way back. Behemoth is back up. Fearless is going to finish off Arcanine. The Root's going to stop too, but it doesn't matter. That's a Kali. Going to get the second kill onto Behemoth. 6-1-2 for Bivon Boop.
Yeah, Bivon Boop really getting those kills, getting online. Already level 18, close to level 20, and once he reaches level 20, he's nigh unstoppable. Meanwhile, more pressure coming out from the mid lane as the taunt goes on to Lord of Evil. It looks like the stun coming out, the fearless coming out, a great CC chain, but the dash is going to come out along with the jump, getting Lord of Evil right out of there. That's the benefit of Sir Cat being so mobile. She can just escape. As soon as she's not being CC'd, she has so many different forms of escape and CC. It's just very safe.
Blue buff being taken here by Bibomboop. It looks like Brick Killer is actually going to secure it with the Umbrella Ring. Trying to do some damage. Bibomboop is very low in mana here, only had enough for the stun. Brick Killer might go ahead and chase this, but Osoth is waiting in the wings to try and help out Bibomboop here. Umbrella Ring is going to hit. Fearless is going to push him out. I don't think he has enough distance to close, even if he has the dash available for him. As Lord of Evil is actually making his way around, might try and get a pick on a Bibomboop. It's going to be just missed there. A little bit late on the timing.
Yeah, Lord of Evil's just gonna run away because he doesn't want to have to fight Osoth.
Yeah, you don't want to fight a tier at this point. He's got his fourth item online. He did opt to go for the Pestilence as opposed to a Bulwark of Hope. Not really much healing on the side, so I'm curious as to why the Pestilence was picked up. Maybe just a protection benefit, a little bit extra magic protection. I believe it's 80 versus 75 or something like that. Not a huge one. As
rushing out the lane. Yeah, but Lord of Evil just being able to get out again with that great mobility. Cardiac just, he throws out those taunts and he forces the mobility out. They really need to have a plan here where, like, Osoth could go in the back lines and secure something after that. The ward being taken, it looks like a huge group up from everybody on Team Sponsor. It looks like they might be looking at the Fire Giant here, seeing as a Lord of Evil back. But looks like they might be baiting it, waiting, just trying to get picks so that they can take the Fire Giant.
Yeah, another ward being placed down to counter ward at the top side of the mid camps there. Arcanine popping his accelerate. Not sure what he's looking to do here. Cardiac's going to dash through two. Taunt's going to come out. Purification force on the Arcanine yet again. Stun's going to come out onto Osoth. Brick Killer's being re-aggressed onto. Wolf goes into the big baby form. Don't think they have a curse to be able to stop that one. It's going to be a disengage from them at the moment. Arcanine going to hit one with the time. Stop time there. Arcanine being re-aggressed on again. No ultimate. He's going to fall to Bibomboop with a few more auto attacks. Brick Killer and Behemoth Lord both on the run. Yeah, Bibomboop's going to jump into the tower. Purification force. Going to go ahead and go into the ultimate very early. Not sure who his target is here. Jumped very low. Fearless Power Cleave is going to be enough to take out Behemoth Lord under the tier 2 tower. Meanwhile, Cute is doing what he can to try and zone out Lord of Evil from making it in. Osoth doing a great job of zoning as they try and take this tier 2 tower in the mid lane. Brick Killer is back. Throws out the damage, but it's not really going to be enough. Cute's off to the side. Tier 2 tower is going to fall in the mid lane.
Yeah, and Lord of Evil and Osoth just clearing up this mid lane. They're trying to get... Team Sponsors has really been focusing down the mid lane here, getting a lot of pressure out. And it looks like... Are they going for the Fire Giant?
Fire Giant is being started up here. Taking a look, Defender of Olympus is coming down onto Cute. Dina has made their way here. It's sitting at about half HP. And Birdkiller is the only one in the area. Tree Vidi is also here. His ultimate is available if he needs to go into that one. Petrify is going to come out from Data members. The Fire Giant has been leased. Lord Evil is going to be aggressed on with the taunt. Snipes are going to miss from Tree Vidi. One more auto attack. Data member is going to get the kill on the Lord of Evil. Force the Fire Giant to be reset, but I don't think there's any reason for them not to go onto it at this point. They don't have any ultimates aside Behemoth Ball on the side of NWFSC as they're aggressing over into the pig camp here on the top side. A little bit of damage goes on to Osoth, but at this point, Tier really doesn't care. He's got enough health, got enough defenses to where a few little abilities like that's not going to do much. Fire Giant has been started back up by Team Sponsor Us, sitting at about maybe about a third HP, and nobody's really available to do anything. Brick Killer and Beautiful's ultimates are available, but Osoth doing an amazing job zoning here at the top by the camps. Team Sponsor Us is going to get the Fire Giant, first one of the game at 27 minutes.
Yeah, really great play, really great strategy coming out from Team Sponsor Us here, being able to get the picks off the Fire Giant even after taking a lot of damage on Data Remember, and their entire team is able to just go back and zone properly and get the Fire Giant after tanking it and tanking it properly and making sure that Behemothal can't come in and steal it with that ultimate or the yawn. And everybody on Team Sponsor Us having the Fire Giant with two people being level 20, two people being level 19, this looks like it's in their favor.
Yeah, it looks like the Gold Fury is going to be looked at once again here by Team Sponsor Us. Really not worth fighting over at this point. I mean, they're already down 11,700 gold and almost 17,000 experience at this point as Gold Fury is taken. It's not an objective worth fighting at the moment, as it looks like they're going to make their aggression here into the dual lane, left-hand side. Cardiac's coming around the back. Tree Fitty's going to be aggressive. It's going to be the blink from Osoth. Not really going to connect anything. Here comes the taunt. Fearless, Power Cleave, Petrify, and that's going to be enough to finish off Tree Fitty as we have a lovely little statue of him being pushed away at the moment. Four members here at the tier two on the left-hand lane. Looks like they're going to be able to take this one. Nobody there to contest, which honestly, this is the best place. The best place to contest these is going to be at the Phoenix, which looks like they'll be the next one to contention. Brick Killer's going to get taunted. Not there to be able to pick up the Fearless. A lot of damage comes onto Behemoth, though Arcanine just kind of missing out on that crush there.
Yeah, looks like this is going to be a really rough fight, seeing as how in WFSD has lost Tree Fitty, a really good source of damage. And this Minion Wave coming in, it looks like Team Sponsoros is going in. Kodiak coming in with a taunt onto Arcanine, forcing the beads out. The Big Baby coming out, along with Lawbringer. Meanwhile, Lord of Evil going on in the back. Big Baby just stomping everything. Lord of Evil being taken out by Bitbomb Boop. Insane damage. Meanwhile, Osoth being ulted on by Athena. Behemothal getting ulted, getting put in that sleepy form, and dying. Cute getting the ultimate onto Brick Hill. Looks like he's chasing Arcanine, and he misses, getting the wrong guess, and they're going to take this Phoenix.
Yeah, Phoenix in the left-hand lane is going to fall. Looks like they're going to make their way towards the mid here. Tree Fitty tried to get those snipes there, but because he doesn't have vision, Bibon Boop just hugs the wall. It doesn't matter. Arcanine's going to get that time break over the wall to take that Arcanine. Fearless Power Cleave's going to come through. Arcanine's likely going to fall here. Great body blocks coming out by Team Sponsors. Make sure he can't go anywhere. Tree Fitty's going to get the return kill, however, onto Data. Remember with the enhance. Q's going to throw out the crush, and it's going to do about half his health. My god, that thing hits hard. Why did we scale that up?
That's a good question. Meanwhile, it looks like we're going to aggress again on this Phoenix. While Behemothal's coming out, Minions actually getting into that Titan room, and the middle Phoenix being taken. The only two places to go now are the right side towers, or the right side tower and the Phoenix.
Yeah, it looks like that's the direction that they're making towards. They're going to go ahead and drop the blue buff here. However, they don't have their main form of actual tower pressure here. Bibon Boop and Data, remember, both down for about the next 15 and 20 seconds. So they're just going to go ahead and clear out the jungle. Lord of Evil's going to aggress onto Osoth, but I mean, that's a tier, and the crush is going to do half of Lord of Evil's health. That's just going to be an immediate disengage from them. Fire minions are finally starting to make their way down the left-hand lane. It looks like they're going to be making their way there towards the middle as well. Yeah, fire minions are in the mid lane now, so they're going to have to send two people just to clear out those two separate lanes.
Yeah, one thing most teams don't know is that getting the left side Phoenix, whenever you're the order side, it puts a lot of pressure onto the enemy team because that's the exact opposite side of the map from the Fire Giant, meaning you have to have somebody over there clearing the wave, otherwise minions will get into your Titan room, and Fire minions do a lot of damage, as we know, and it gives a lot of easy access to taking a Fire Giant.
Yeah, you always want to try and get the Phoenix opposite of the Fire Giant first if you can. Otherwise, the mid one is also a great one. They still have a little bit further to go into. But as you were saying, left-hand side, or if you're on the Chaos, right-hand side. Basically, just opposite dual lane side Phoenix is the one that you want to prioritize over anything else. And really, the solo lane is we have a little bit of aggression here into the jungle. Lord Evil's going to have a lot of damage hooked into him, but Bibon Boop's going to be able to chase him down. He's got that Fatalis. Also has a Wing Blade. A lot of movement speed coming out of this Kali here. Sprint has been popped by Lord of Evil. He's going to get out of that one. Time Rip's going to come through at the top hand side. It's going to hit three people, but it doesn't matter. Behemothal's going to fall. Lawbringer's going to come over the top from Osoth. That's going to be another kill onto Arcanine. And if they pick off even one more here, that's going to be the game. True Fitty forced into the Sanctuary. Doesn't matter. He's going to fall. Bibon Boop's going to get credit for that. Lord of Evil's going to get taunted out. Cute's going to get the kill with the I'm a Monster. They're going to be able to pull it onto Brick Killer as well. He's sitting in there. Bibon Boop's going aggressive in the fountain. He's not going to be able to get the kill on that one. And Crush is doing a lot to make sure that Brick Killer can't heal. Defender of Olympus is coming through. They're just going to work their way onto the site. He's sitting at 5,000. 4,000, dropping very low. Bear Killer's not going to be able to do anything. Taunt's going to come out. Titan's sitting at 1,500 HP. Data Remember's going to get the kill on that, and that's going to be the game going to Team Sponsor Us.
Who would have guessed?
I mean, at the beginning, NWFSC was putting up a really great fight, getting those early picks off. But when it came down to it, Behemothal was just falling way too far behind compared to Kardiak. Arcanine, never able to hit that level 20. Just in general, NWFSC started falling behind in the mid-late game as we go ahead and just kind of look at the stats real quick before we go into a break. Brick Killer wasn't really able to do much that game. Was at 0-6. Behemothal was at 0-5. Really, Lord of Evil was the only one really doing much on the team that game. Arcanine also 3-7, and Tree Fitty only at 2-3. Meanwhile, Kali, Bibon Boop was able to get up to 10-2-10.
It's crazy. Getting Kali good. Getting good kills and getting farm on Kali, just leading into the late game, just leads to such great kills, because it's not that difficult once you get the farm online. It's just hold left click, hold W, and aim the mouse. Sometimes you throw out ability, sometimes you don't need to.
Yeah, I mean, in a lot of cases, you just need the stun, and then the stun lash, and then from there, you just auto-attack, because that's all that matters. It's how Kali works. When the attack chain as well, coupled with Kinsai's, it's probably... I think Kali is the best god to utilize Kinsai's just because of how fast her attack chain is, and was able to get so much movement speed. I don't know if you noticed, Fatalis, Stonecutting Sword, and Wingblade. Three items that give, I believe, 10% movement speed each. Kali was... Kali was the fastest thing on the map. I don't even think Mercury could have caught Kali at that point.
Because Mercury's, for some reason, not the fastest assassin.
Nah, I'll never understand that one. But, I mean, great game coming out from both teams here. NWFSC will fall down into the loser's bracket, and we'll have a shot at coming back. But Team Sponsors is going to move on into winner's semifinals. We're going to go ahead and cut to a short break as we get ready to get set up for our next match, which is going to be Team Sponsor Us versus KSU Thor Losers.
And that is going to be a great match.
Yeah, that one will be coming up here within about the next 15 minutes or so. So we're just going to go ahead and cut to a break, and we'll come back whenever that match is ready to go.